Hi students, let's continue with the data communications. The next topic was IPv4. So what is this IPv4? IP, Internet Protocol version 4. So what is the use of this protocol? Let's see. So before going to deep introduction about the IPv4 version, let's see what is an IP. So we already discussed IP is nothing but Internet Protocol. Internet Protocol. So it's just an address, so to where you want to go and from where we have to get the data. So it's completely based on the Internet Protocol address. So it is just a numeric address. Okay, we are talking about the IP, Internet Protocol address. It is a numeric address. It's an identifier for a computer or a device on a network. So we just call it as an identifier. Identifier for a computer or device on a network. Okay. So if you want to send the information to some of the destination or to some of the system or to some of the computer, you need to identify an address. So that address is nothing but the Internet Protocol address. So with the help of the Internet Protocol address on a network, you can identify the destination device. Every device has an IP address for communication purpose. So the Internet Protocol has two parts. IP has two parts. So what are the two parts? One is network address, and another is the host address. Network address. So on which network you are putting the data. So that is a network address. And the host address is nothing but the destination address from where to where you are sending the data. So that IP, Internet Protocol address, has two parts. One is the network address and host address. So there are two types of internet protocols. So what are the two types of internet protocols? One is the IPv4 and another is the IPv6. That is the Internet Protocol version 4, and another is the Internet Protocol version 6. V4 is the version 4, V6 is nothing but the version 6. Let's see what is this Internet Protocol version 4. Okay, so let me explain the Internet Protocol version 4. So IPv4 is the current version of IP address. So whatever we are using at present is the Internet Protocol version 4. So it is a 32-bit numeric address. It is a 32-bit numeric 32-bit numeric address, which is written as 4 numbers separated by a period. So let me show you one example. It's just an example. Let me take 66.94.234.13. So this is a period. So it is a 32-bit numeric address which has written as a 4 numbers. So these are the 4 numbers separated with a dot period. So here this each one you call it as an octant. Okay, each number with the dot period, this is one octant, another octant. Octant is number of range. So the complete range is range of octant. So whatever you are taken, that octant range is from 0 to 255. So this range is 0 to 255. This octant range is 0 to 255. Like that, whatever the octant you are taken, that range is from 0 to 255. Okay. So don't be confused. Internet Protocol version 4 is a current version of IP address, whatever we are using. It is a 32-bit numeric address. Okay, that 32-bit numeric address written as a 4 numbers. Okay, 4 numbers separated by a dot period. So each part you call it as an octant. This octant should be in the range of 0 to 255. Okay, so here the computer and network don't read the IP address in this standard numeric format. Okay. So actually, if you written like this, the computer and whatever the network that you are placing the data, so it doesn't understand. So whatever the numeric address you are given, that will be converted into binary format. Okay, convert into binary format. Binary format means it's nothing but numbers in the form of ones and zeros. Now let's see the binary number for an IP address. So whatever the IP address here you are given, let me take another example. So let me convert the, find out binary number for an IP address which is written in, let's take 66.94.29.13. So this is the IP address which is in the decimal form. I want to convert into binary number so that the system can understand. So how you are going to convert? Actually, the answer for this you will get is the conversion is 01000010. Okay, 00011100011011. So this is a binary conversion for this decimal numbers. How you will get this? Let me see. Let me take each octant and explain how I get this demo. Okay. So this, let me take the binary conversion. IPv4 binary conversion. IPv4 binary conversions. So actually the 8-bit octant chart, how it will look like? 8-bit octant chart. So this consisting of 128-bit, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. So this is a chart. 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Okay. So let me take the first decimal number 66.94.29.13. So the first, let take the first octant, how I can convert this into binary numbers. Okay, so how can I convert this into binary numbers? So let me take 66 means 64 plus 2, you will get 66. Okay, 64 plus 2 is nothing but 66. So just place 1 here and 1 in 2 and the remaining all zeros. So that is the value of 66. So the 66 decimal conversion to binary is 01000010. So next is 94. So 94 is a combination of let's take 64 plus 16. Okay, 64 plus 16, you will get total 80. 80 plus 88 plus 4 plus 2, you will get 94. So, in that places, just place 1 here. 64 is 1, 16 is 1, 8 is 1, 4 is 1, 2 is 1, and the remaining all are zeros. Okay, then what is the 60, next 94? 94 is a combination of 01011110. So this is the way you will get the value. So in the same way, you just convert all the decimal numbers into binary conversion. Okay, so you will get 0 and 29, you will get 00011101 00000110. Okay, so this is just a conversion. 8-bit octant chart conversion. Thank you.